likely a possibility as that it involves DNA, that it involves binding into a molecular site where information is stored, so that this information is then broadcast in essentially in the mind in such a way that you begin to get a readout on the structure of the soul. In other words, this was an effort to use a kind of shamanic technology to bell the cat, if you will, to hang a superconducting, telemetric, psychedelic device on the overmind so that there would be a continuous readout of information from this dimension. And the success or failure of this, you may judge by reading the book, because the first half of the book describes the experiment, the theoretical underpinning of the experiment. The second half of the book describes the theory of the structure of time that derived from the bizarre mental states that followed upon the experiment. I don't claim that we succeeded. I just claim that our theory of what happened is better than any theory whether we succeeded or not, that kind of thinking points the way. In other words, when I speak of the technology of building the starship, I imagine it will be done with voltages far below the voltage of a common flashlight battery. This is, after all, where the voltages, where the most interesting phenomenon go on in nature. Thought is that kind of phenomenon. Metabolism is that kind of phenomenon. So, I think that, you know, an Aquarian science, or a science that places the psychedelic experience at the center of its program of investigation, should move toward a practical realization of this goal. The goal of eliminating the barrier between the ego and the overself, so that the ego can perceive itself as an expression of the overself, so that the anxiety of being cast into matter, of apparently facing a tremendous biological crisis in the form of death, of apparently facing a tremendous physical species crisis in the form of the apocalypse, the crisis of limitation in physical space by being planet-bound, all of these things can be obviated by cultivating the soul, basically, by practicing shamanism using these tryptamine drugs that I've described. And my plea to scientists, administrators, and politicians who may be listening to my voice is to look again at psilocybin, to not lump it with the other psychedelics, to realize that it is a phenomenon unto itself, and it has an enormous potential for transforming mankind, not simply transforming the people who take it, but it is like an art movement or a mathematical understanding.